Could low normal phosphorus be from my calcium intake?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Alicia Caver, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, Caver, I'm not sure, has a second question. Thanks to your incredible Vitamins and Minerals 101 course and patiently waiting for what I think is going to be the best practical book on nutrition ever, smiley face. Thank you, Alicia. I was shocked to realize that my calcium intake was not even close to high enough. After months of doing milk yogurt daily and traditional foods market brand whole bone meal to fill in the gaps, I tested to see how I was doing. Vitamin D at 37.8, assume this is nanograms per milliliter. Calcitriol at 38.6 picograms per milliliter out of a range of 19.9 to 79.3. PTH 18 out of a range of 15 to 65 picograms per milliliter. Serum phosphorus 3.1, which is toward the bottom of a range of 3.0 to 4.3. Serum calcium 9.1, which is toward the middle-ish of a range of 8.7 to 10.2. Do you think it's normal for PTH to be this suppressed by calcium repletion alone, or could something else be going on that I need to pay attention to? I wonder if my phosphorus being rather low in the range could be relevant somehow. Given that your calcium is coming from milk and yogurt and traditional foods market brand whole bone meal to get your calcium, you're definitely consuming plenty of phosphorus. And so I don't think your dietary phosphorus is off. I wouldn't really worry about the phosphorus being low in that range. It's not low. It's on the low end of the range. I think the PTH being suppressed to 18 is great. I think the calcium doing that is great. I think that the calcium did that even when all your calcium sources were balanced by phosphorus. Sounds really good because phosphorus would do the opposite. If you're on a very low carbohydrate diet, or you especially if you shifted to one, and then especially if you ate more carbohydrate recently before the test, or if you've been fasting a lot and refeeding, either of those could lower the serum phosphorus level. Right now, the serum phosphorus is not low. And as long as your alkaline phosphatase doesn't go up, and if you're measuring your bone mineral content, that would probably be good to measure, but I wouldn't really insist on it if you're not already doing that. But as long as there's no problems on those fronts, and as long as the serum phosphorus doesn't slip out of the range low, I wouldn't worry about it too much. But I would definitely be curious as to whether either of those things about carbohydrate fluctuating or fasting apply in your case. Maybe follow up with the serum phosphorus next time you do testing to see where it goes. All right, thank you, Alicia, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.